Minneapolis is, in a really interesting way, a vanguard city. And it has always been this kind of mythical city in that way for me, in terms of culture, in terms of music, in terms of offering this kind of alternative way of being urban. But it's also East Africa there. It's also Ethiopia there. I grew up in Ethiopian households in the Midwest. So this community that I engaged with there felt very familiar, and it was amazing to be able to like combine these worlds in a way that felt important. The Walker is really dear to me. It's the first museum where I ever had a solo show in 2003. It's the first museum that created a catalog for me and created a book where I worked very closely with curators. So I'm super excited to be back at the Walker. The exhibition is 25 years of work. It starts with my early work in grad school, and then it really concludes with the most recent work. It has, I think, 30-something paintings, 30-something drawings. Of all the bodies of work I've done, I think the majority, outside of the most recent work, the biggest group of works included in the exhibition were all exhibited in my first show here at the Walker. And so for me, this exhibition, you know, it's just an incredible honor. My time at the Walker was super formative and super important for teaching me how to hang a show and really thinking about paintings in relation to each other, and paintings as bodies of work, paintings as cycles of work, paintings as an installation. And I tried to think about the paintings in relation to the residency project that I was doing, which was called Minneapolis and St. Paul or East African Cities. And so in thinking of that project and then seeing this kind of vista of Minneapolis from the Walker window, from the gallery, I made a large panoramic painting that was the entrance painting at the Walker. And that painting responded to the city outside of Minneapolis. That was this architectural and colonial historical map of Africa, of the continent, in this kind of really absurd way, in a way, from pre-colonial to post-colonial narratives included in that architecture. So it was this way of thinking of St. Paul and Minneapolis and this mirroring of these two different types of urban experiences on top of one another and the conceptual space that you can layer in that. And that's something that has carried on with my work since, thinking of the Howell paintings in the SF MoMA lobby. And then I did the painting at the Whitney that was site-specific for the wall facing the Hudson River. That experience of the painting in relation to the city and in relation to the window and the sighting of that, that was something that I think really began in that exhibition of the Walker. My studio practice is a very internal one. The way that I make work comes from a very self-generated internal practice. What I try to do and have done always is find ways to connect with communities that I think are important and to do other forms of work outside of the studio. When I first went to Minneapolis, I was immediately wanting to work with this community because they so much reflected my experience growing up as an Ethiopian immigrant to the Midwest. Really, what I was interested in is, who are all these individuals who are here? What are their narratives? What are their stories? And they are deeply as part of Minneapolis as much as anything else. And so the conceptual idea of the artist residency was St. Paul and Minneapolis as East African cities. We created these self-ethnography research kits. One of the ideas was, wherever they are in the city, where they want to take photographs or record sounds or document parts of their life, they would do this for a week. They would mark themselves on the map, take a photograph, mark that on the map, and they would be able to like have this kind of map and narrative of their own lives in the city. We put all those maps together and created a website where all this information lived. So it became this collective imaging, but based off of these very specific individual narratives. The other thing that was great is that that entire collection and that archive was then put into the Historical Society in Minneapolis. So that is part of their archive. They are part of that history and this claiming of that space in that way. What was also super special about this project is that it brought a community into the museum that wouldn't normally necessarily come to the museum. I think that these kinds of programs are essential for expanding who participates, who are contributors and participants in the kind of creation of this form of new knowledge. The art world and the history of contemporary art and making needs really interesting and important practitioners. It can't be homogeneous. If we're really thinking about a museum as a living entity that is kind of participating in the creation of new knowledge, then its role is, as a public institution, is to participate and really ensure that the full public has access to that and that students have access to that.